went through a little bit of pain early on the year against Derry in the National League and against Cork in the Munster final. And, you know, after those losses, you know, there was a bit of soul searching and we had to obviously rethink our situation. And, you know, we had to go and do some extra hard work. And, you know, thankfully everybody knuckled in and got the work done. And, you know, we got, you know, got into the qualifiers. And obviously after that, you know, things started to take off.
It's a very fine line between success and failure, and I suppose we're very fortunate that the back door, the qualifiers, call what you will, exists, because if it didn't, we'd be out of the championship on a night in Newry in June, and that would be a very bad season. Thank God we got the second chance. We were probably fortunate in the draw, seemed to be getting progressively tougher for us along the way, and we were fortunate again that we got a fortnight between the Mayo game and the Dublin game.
Tyrone are a super team. They seem to be peaking at the right time. They seem to be coming at a very good time of the year, and we are going to find it, you know, quite tough, you know, to be able to stay up to their intensity. Only Kerry's playing the way the players want. I mean, you know, this is all about players making decisions for themselves, and this particular team is so experienced, and they've been down a lot of long roads, and they've played so long. This is the fifth All-Ireland in a row, so that experience and that, you know, is something that you have to work on. And, you know, thankfully we have players that have taken responsibility on their shoulders and shown leadership at different times in the year, and that's all you can ask of the players.
We had what people describe as the marquee forwards in 2005 with Peter Canham and Stephen O'Neill and Owen Mulligan excelling, a great full forward line, and currently this year we really haven't had any of them to date. Now that both Owen Mulligan's available and injury free as well, and Stevie's back in the frame, then at least two thirds of it is available to us. Peter Canham isn't coming back, by the way. He has definitely decided to stay retired. But I think it has made other players look to improve their own game, maybe to look to take more responsibility. It's spreading the load, and maybe that's reflected in the number of people that have been scoring for us in the last couple of games. We've racked up good scores, and it's come from a variety of sources.
It's just great that Paul is back, to be honest about it. It's been a very trying year for him. We're all thrilled that he's got an opportunity to put on the green and gold jersey again. You know, I mean, he's come back into training. He's been welcomed back by the group. Thankfully, everything is behind him. And now he can go and look forward to an All-Ireland final, which is great. He's obviously trying to get a little bit of football under his belt now. He hasn't played in any National League, and he hasn't played practically in a championship besides 50 minutes against Clare. So that'll probably, you know, be a little against him. But, you know, he's willing. You know, he's obviously very enthusiastic. You know, he's huge hunger, because he's been sitting idly by waiting for his chance to come back. So, you know, he's got all the credentials, and I'm sure that he's only, you know, waiting for the day to happen.
Kerry have a lot of armoury in their artillery. They can vary the game any way they want. They can play the pass and running game. They can play the long ball. You know, they have great fetchers across the field. So I think they've got lots of things. We certainly can't match them in terms of the aerial stakes. So therefore we have to adapt to play the game that suits us best. And obviously that's got to do with a lot of high energy stuff. We've got to work hard. We've got to support each other. We've got to, you know, as you say, perhaps keep the ball, you know, in control and not give it away. We can't toss it up in the air between a 6 foot six man and a 5 foot ten. That doesn't make sense. So I suppose we'd have to be more careful in our possession, where Kerry can afford to be, not say careless, but more carefree.
The most important thing for me is that, you know, we represent our county, and we're very proud of the fact that we get the opportunity to perform, you know, more Sundays. And look, it's the pinnacle of every footballer's dream. You know, every September you look forward to the All-Ireland final, and, you know, we're just thankful, you know, from the start of the year we set ourselves a goal to get back here. You know, at times during the year it didn't look maybe great, but these lads are a special group of players, and, you know, they stuck in there when times were tough, and, you know, they got the rewards. And as I say, we've a full panel to pick from now with Darragh and Paul back, and everybody here in the county is just really, really looking forward to it.
It's never easy to prepare for an All-Ireland final, and people often said, or been quoted in the past, in Kerry got easy All-Irelands. There are no easy All-Irelands. To win the All-Ireland, you have to beat the best that's put before you in any given season. Kerry did that and deserve total credit for it. They're in their fifth final in a row, so they're well versed on dealing with finals. As far as we're concerned, we're happy to call on the experiences of 03 and 05, and you have to have that in the locker room, so to speak, bring out the things that were useful. So we won't be in awe of playing in a final. We know what the atmosphere is like. We know what the opponents are like. We've met them at serious stages of the competition before. So we're in a happy enough position. We're not a novice side going into the final. I suppose in relative terms, we're new to the scene. But contemporary team that's actually challenging for honours in the last 5 or 6 years also must stand to us.